Gary Krieger says, would a seasonally low vitamin D level, he lives in northern Michigan, combined with a high calcium intake, 1,500 to 2,000, he must mean milligrams, 500 milligrams from supplements, so 1,000 to 1,500 from diet, 500 milligrams from supplements, would this increase the risk for soft tissue calcification if vitamin A, K2, magnesium levels were adequate, or would the calcium simply be excreted due to low vitamin D levels? I'll take the first step.
I was like, one. That's a better question for you, Chris.
This is a Chris question. Okay, so with a seasonally low vitamin D level, despite high calcium, would that increase, Gary, if you can follow up, I'm not sure if you're asking, would the low vitamin D level increase the soft tissue calcification, or would the high calcium do so?
Or both. You could answer either way.
Yeah. Okay. So the end of this question is, would the calcium simply be excreted due to the low vitamin D levels? So your vitamin D level being low, the first thing that's going to do, and the major thing that's going to do, is it's going to lower your calcium absorption. And so you would have more calcium excreted in the feces as a result of not absorbing it if your vitamin D level is low. However, a high enough calcium intake is going to more than compensate for that. So it depends how low it is. I mean, if you live in northern Michigan and you're not supplementing with vitamin D in the winter, but you're outdoors a lot, your vitamin D is probably not going like rickets level low. it's probably dipping a bit. And a calcium intake of 2,000 milligrams is so high that you're probably absorbing at least enough calcium. And the vitamin D being low, then once the calcium is in your system, one of the problems with low vitamin D is that it's going to take more calcium to suppress your parathyroid hormone, and you want your parathyroid hormone maximally suppressed for the sake of your bone health. But again, a high calcium intake like that may well completely compensate for that. Now, the soft tissue calcification is going to be driven by, on the one side, so you can view it as like a calcium in, calcium out. You could view it as a pro-calcification, anti-calcification equation. And so the calcium phosphate product, which is the concentration of calcium in your blood times the concentration of phosphorus in your blood, is going to be the pro-calcification side of that equation. And the protective factors that are like the proteins that are made by A, D, and activated by K2, the magnesium, and a couple other things are going to be defending the soft tissues against calcification. And so the low vitamin D is probably not going to change your calcium phosphate product that much. The calcium intake, I mean, 2,000 milligrams, I think, is pushing the safe limit of calcium. It's not necessarily harmful, but calcium doesn't have a huge window. I think 1,000 to 2,000 milligrams is probably the safe window for calcium. It depends how low the vitamin D levels are. So like if it's going down to 20 or 25 nanograms per milliliter, it's probably not going to interfere that much with the ability of the other things to defend you against soft tissue calcification, but below that it might. And if it's dipping from like 60 to 40 nanograms per milliliter, it's probably just that, you know, vitamin D has a U-shaped curve with calcification. So you don't want to be deficient. But when you get up into 50, 60 nanograms per milliliter, you're not asking the question of whether you need more vitamin D to protect against soft tissue calcification. You're asking whether you might have too much. If it's going down to 30, no issue at all. If it's going down to like 20 or 25, you might want to measure your vitamin D levels, your parathyroid hormone levels, and use a little bit of extra vitamin D if you need to normalize those levels. Bring 25-OHD up to 30-ish or a little higher, bring PTH to 30-ish or lower, And yeah, that's my thought. Do you have anything to add, Carrie?
Nope. Okay. I like it.
All right, cool.